Today, once again, I'm coming to you from Country Classic Cars here in Staunton, Illinois. And I thought you might like a look at this 1954 Cadillac Eldorado Convertible. And this is a very original survivor, meaning that it has all its original interior, original drivetrain, everything. So I definitely thought it was worth taking a look at. You can see all the chrome's looking nice up front here. Then you have your Cadillac badging right on the front of the hood. With a pretty impressive hood ornament up top here as well. You can see the chrome's nice and smooth on that. And I do believe it's been repainted at some point. But other than that one repaint, it looks to be pretty much all original. Of course, nice little bits of trim on these Cadillacs. I mean, Cadillac really was a status symbol at that time. It was definitely one of the finest cars in the world. You can see the front fenders kind of shroud the front wheels there. It is riding on a set of real wire wheels with wide whites. Those are probably Kelsey Hayes wire wheels. Got your Cadillac badges on the fenders. It has a nice big wraparound windshield. That's in nice shape. And the top's still looking good on it. It's a little dirty here and there, but there's no rips or tears or anything. Here, I'll take a peek inside. Like I said, it is all original interior. You can see the original door panels there. And of course, it does have power windows. It also has crank-out vent windows at the front corner there. Nice big bench seat. It's a 50-50 split back bench seat. All original leather. And of course, rear seat to match. I mean, it's just been really well preserved. Pretty cool. It still has the factory steering wheel with a full horn hoop. And a pretty nice looking dashboard. 110 mile per hour speedometer. And it's showing 22,652 miles. Obviously, I don't know. It's probably 122, but I'm not sure. It does have a padded dashboard, and that's in good shape. And you can see how that dashboard wraps all the way around into the door panel there at the pillar. Pretty impressive. Man, that thing feels nice and solid. Definitely well-built cars for sure. Like I said, just nice little bits of trim on these Cadillacs. It does have the rear fender skirts as well. It has these sort of bulbous fins, you know, not the really tall fins that came out a bit later. And one cool feature, much like the later Chevrolets, your fuel filler is actually hidden underneath this tail light, so you just push this button right here and then this lifts up and there's your fuel filler. Pretty cool. And it's kind of tight against the wall here, but you can see it does have a big chrome bumper at the back and it has the exhaust that comes out the corners of the bumper. I'll go around the other side there and we'll take a better look at it. Definitely a massive car for a two-door. They were built to excess for sure. I mean, this one's in really nice shape though. The body's nice and straight all the way around. We'll see if we can get a better look at the back. You can see the bumper a little better there. And there's the exhaust coming out. Definitely a cool car. And like I said, this one is still powered by the original Cadillac V8. Let's go ahead and pop open the hood and we'll take a look under there. Alright, as you can see, they basically left everything factory original under here. In fact, it's still wearing the original paint on the valve covers and block and everything. And it has that really cool air cleaner up top. That's the one that you see end up on a bunch of hot rods. But has a really nice look to it. Like I said, all original equipment under here. Very nice. And actually, I think we'll go ahead and have them start it up for you so you can hear what it sounds like. Alright, let's go ahead and check out the specs on it. Once again, it's a 1954 Cadillac Eldorado Convertible. And 100% original interior. And they're saying there's a chance that's the actual mileage on there. That'd be pretty awesome. But these are definitely highly collectible cars. I mean, these Cadillacs from the 50s, like I said, they were kind of the ultimate status symbol at the time. Well, anyway, guys, I just thought you'd like a look at that one. As always, I do appreciate you watching and commenting and everything. And we'll see you in the next one. Bye.